Do you like big guns? Like really big autoguns with mind-blowing rates of fire? If you're a fan of overwhelming firepower and cutting-edge military technology, then you're in the right place. Get ready to dive into the world of some of the most formidable and sophisticated autoguns ever deployed by the US military. From rapid-fire Gatling guns to ground-shaking 50mm chain guns, we're about to explore the lead-spitting giants that dominate the battlefield.
Yo, come on, man. They're about to do a gun run. You need to get down. Let's go, buddy.
First, let's take a look at a real Hellraiser. It's an old idea whose destructive power has increased more than tenfold thanks to technological advances. A weapon that is a favorite of both Hollywood productions and video games. It is time to let old Painless out the bag. Or, as it is known in the real world, the M134 Minigun. The origins of this weapon can be traced back to the Civil War. Back in the days of the Civil War, Richard Jordan Gatling invented a multi-barreled rotating gun operated by a hand crank that could fire up to 200 rounds a minute. In 1956, the gun was standardized as the M61 20mm cannon and entered service with both the United States Army and Air Force. Choppers played a vital role in the conflict as they allowed for swift vertical takeoffs and landings, which traditional aircraft couldn't accomplish. They frequently came under attack when coming in to land, forcing their crews to use single-barrel guns to defend themselves. However, these weapons proved to be ineffective as the jungle caused them to jam or overheat. This prompted the US to look for a solution. General Electric scaled down the M61 and changed the barrels to fit the 7.62mm by 51mm NATO cartridge to create the M134 minigun. While the gun certainly wasn't mini, it earned the minigun name from being a smaller version of the M61. This gun doesn't have a handheld version, and there are very good reasons for that. The gun alone weighs 85 pounds. Now, add the weight of the ammunition box, the feeding mechanism, the power source, and that insane rate of fire. Also, you are not a cyborg. You can see where we are getting at. So the M134 was used on a number of helicopters and also saw service in a number of underwing pods, allowing aircraft such as the AD-1 Sky Raider to deliver tremendous amounts of firepower in CAS missions. Thanks to the morale and fire support provided by its incredible firepower, this weapon has become one of the indispensable iconic weapons of the American military. Functionally, the gun unit is a little different from Dr. Richard Jordan Gatling's original design, being effectively a rack of six straight-pull bolt-action rifles attached to a rotor assembly with a common ammunition feed, with cams operating their bolts as they rotate. The first production model fired at a fixed 6,000 RPM thanks to its multi-barrel design, but this was found to cause too many mechanical issues, and a transmission housing was added to the motor, giving a selectable fire rate of 2,000 or 4,000 RPM. The gun drive motor powers the drive gear head, both are mounted on the side of the gun unit. The drive gear head determines the speed at which the weapon fires. The gun control unit is mounted to the back of the gun unit, distributes power to the components of the gun, and is responsible for timing the operation of the electrical mechanisms. The feeder or delinker is a necessary component as the M134 has no internal belt feeder but usually feeds from standard machine gun belts. As a result, the links must be separated outside of the gun. The gun requires an external 24-volt DC power supply of at least 58 amps of current in order to function, which is usually provided by a large battery pack or a generator attached to the engine of whatever the gun is mounted on. The US Army continues to call it the M134, while the Air Force and Navy refer to it as the GAU-2A when it is fixed-mounted, and the GAU-17A, which is the crew-served version with a flexible mount. The original M134 is still used to this day by different branches of the US military. When people say size doesn't matter, the designers of this weapon surely chuckled and thought, challenge accepted. In a daring feat of design, they crafted an immensely powerful gun that, against all the odds, remains sleek and seamlessly integrates with current combat platforms. While it may be only a little larger than the famous 22mm M242, this weapon system astonishingly doubles the ammunition diameter, packing a punch that's hard to rival. Born from audacity and sheer engineering prowess, the devastating power of this weapon makes even the Apache helicopter's 30mm M230 look modest by comparison. The XM913 is the most powerful chain gun ever constructed. Chain guns are unique. They use a single barrel and bolt driven by a mechanical chain and motor instead of the recoil from the bullet's discharge. This design means the firing rate is controlled by the motor's speed, and any misfired round gets ejected, enhancing the gun's reliability. Drawing inspiration from the Mark IV-4S and Bush III cannons, the XM913 offers unmatched versatility and superiority in combat. It features a semi-closed bolt firing mechanism, the option for first round selection, and the convenience of a remote safe actuator, allowing for remote toggling between firing and safety modes. This gun is a more advanced, slightly enlarged adaptation of the 25mm Bushmaster cannon. The total length of the 25mm cannon is 105.2 inches, while the 50mm cannon stretches to 117.7 inches. With shells measuring 50 by 228 millimeters, XM913 ammunition has twice the diameter of the 25 by 137 millimeter M242 Bushmaster rounds. The XM913 showcases versatility, firing both XM1204 High Explosive Airburst with Trace, or HEABT, and XM1203 Armor-Piercing Fin-Stabilized Discarding Sabot with Trace, or APF-SDST ammunition. With this ability to hit targets from a staggering distance of over 2.5 miles, it offers double the range of Bradley's current M242 25mm cannon. Well, no big gun video would be complete without mentioning the following juggernaut. Enter the GAU-8 Avenger. The most powerful autocannon ever mounted on an aircraft was crafted to decimate main battle tanks and pulverize armored columns. Its distinct sound is a symphony for US ground forces. And for those unfortunate enough to hear it, it is a nightmare. The Cold War era saw an arms race between global superpowers. The GAU-8 Avenger was conceived as a powerful answer to the formidable armored divisions of the Soviet Union. This wasn't just a weapon for an aircraft. The A-10 Thunderbolt II, colloquially named the Warthog, was essentially constructed around the GAU-8 Avenger. The relationship was so intertwined that without the gun, the aircraft had to be propped up to avoid tipping backward. To grasp the GAU-8's size, visualize it next to a Chevrolet sedan. Excluding other components, the gun stretches 9.35 feet, and with the ammunition feed system, a whopping 19.7 feet. Each barrel extends 7.55 feet. As for weight, when devoid of ammo, it stands at around 619 pounds. When fully packed, the combined weight of the gun and ammunition hovers close to 3,968 pounds. Drawing from the 19th century Gatling gun design, the GAU-8 is an intricate assembly of seven barrels rotating around a central axis. Instead of the Gatling's hand crank mechanism, the GAU-8 uses two hydraulic motors. As the central axis spins, cams guide each barrel through a cyclical process of loading, firing, unloading, and then reloading. What sets the GAU-8 apart is its self-sustaining firing system. Neither the recoil nor the gas from the discharged rounds drive the gun, ensuring that a misfired round doesn't halt subsequent firing. Powering this monumental weapon requires an intricate balance of mechanical and hydraulic energy. The dual hydraulic motors ensure the rapid, seamless rotation of the gun barrel assembly. This rotation, driven by the aircraft's power systems, facilitates the gun's extraordinary firing rates and ensures the stability of the entire mechanism, even under intense operation. The ammunition employed by the GAU-8 is a tale of engineering genius. Each shell is a 30 by 173mm cannon round, available in three variants. The armor-piercing incendiary variant is cloaked in an aluminum jacket, which protects its formidable core made of depleted uranium. This is complemented by a high-explosive incendiary and a more economically feasible target practice round. The size? Think about a standard Coca-Cola bottle. That's approximately the size of one of these rounds. Opting for lightweight aluminum cartridges over conventional brass or steel significantly increases the aircraft's ammo-carrying capacity. The magazine holds up to 1,174 rounds, but typically 1,150 rounds are loaded, given the 575-round capacity of the loading cart. Upon initiation, the GAU-8's firepower is evident, dispersing 50 rounds within its first second. It subsequently intensifies to 65 rounds every second, translating to 4,200 rounds in a minute. Its accuracy doesn't disappoint either. 80% of its shots, when fired from 3,937 feet, fall within a 39.4-foot diameter. With closely matching ballistic performances across ammo types, the PGU-14 API armor-piercing round exhibits a muzzle velocity of 3,323 feet per second. This projectile, weighing in at 0.87 pounds, generates an energy output of approximately 203,000 joules. This energy is tenfold that of the acclaimed 0.50 BMG rounds. No car or tank offers adequate protection against this weapon. It slices through armor as effortlessly as a hot knife glides through butter. Engineers masterfully coupled the A-10 with a GAU-8 Avenger, crafting a union that elevated the A-10 to legendary status among aviation icons. The US Air Force has committed to retaining the iconic A-10 Warthog close air support jet until 2040, ensuring that the legendary GAU-8 Avengers Symphony resonates for over another decade. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the big autoguns of the US military. There are, of course, many other remarkable weapon systems in the US military's inventory. So, what do you think about these iconic guns? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the guns mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, operated or maintained one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.